only pays 65 cents on the dollar, but, you know, I'll just fully admit, if you've been watching the program for the last couple of weeks, I haven't made any bones about it. Like, I don't handicap college basketball well enough to where I can sit here and say, like, oh yeah, the Zags are going to cover, you know, Michigan's going to cover, but I'm confident enough in the team's winning, right? I mean, I did it last night as well.
Yeah.
Same deal. That one paid right at 65 cents on the dollar as well. So just easier for me as a bettor because I don't know the minutiae of college basketball quite as well as far as, like, you know, what teams tend to keep their foot on the gas, what teams will kind of start to rest. Does it even change as we get further on into the tournament, stuff like that? Like, that's not really stuff that's in my wheelhouse. And so mm-hmm. I just take the point spreads out.
Well, and I said this on the radio side this morning, and I'll take a moment to say this again. If I've tried to do anything on a numbers game, I think if we've tried to do anything here on Primetime Action, is sort of try to get people thinking outside of the construct box, if you will, of everything is ATS preflop, right? Everybody talks, justifiably to some degree, because that's the language that sports bettors have been reared on, about against the spread preflop bets. Well, there's so many other ways to bet things, and just to give an example as to why I will never believe betting college basketball at this point in the season is proper to do so ATS, or at least not proper, but is not a long-term winning proposition, again, going back to Survivor. In Survivor, you just have to pick one team to win every day in the tournament, and then you can't use them again. All you have to do is to pick one team to win. That's all. And we literally went from 166 entries to 12 in a span of 6 days of basketball. 6 days? Yeah, 6 days of basketball before the Elite Eight. 166 to 12. And you mean to tell me you're going to win this long-term betting against the spread?
Right. I was never sweating that game last night, but everybody else in the world was.
Yeah.
Because it came down to will they, won't they foul, and like will they, won't they make free throws. Whatever. I was never sweating that because I just had a money line.
Right.
So I'm not, you know, that was never a problem for me. But like you're saying, like it was – we watched it happening. We were counting it down. We go, wow, this is going to fall right on the number. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. This is going to fall right on the number. And sure enough, it was going to fall right on the number.
And let me repeat. I'm sure there are people who do beat college basketball. As we know they do early in college basketball seasons. But by this time of year, the lines are the most calibrated of all of them. What Matt is referring to is Wayne Tinkle, the head coach of Oregon State, yesterday calling a timeout, in essence, to say don't foul.
Right.
And so our own Danielle Alvari hit the under as a result, and Oregon State plus the points, as Houston didn't have a chance to shoot a couple more free throws that might have altered that, as Houston won that game 67-61, and those of us who are still alive in Survivor, like myself, went down with